Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our biology lesson, that is management of natural resources. In the introductory topic of this lesson, I have explained you various few things which are very important points related to this topic. That is concept of resource. What is meant by exactly resource? Then the concept of waste. Resource and concept of waste are two different. After it, natural resources, man-made resources, then exhaustible resources and inexhaustible resources also I have explained you. Renewable and non-renewable resources also I have given you the acquisition of it. So you don't have to worry, I am going to give you in the notes form all these three differences to you. Okay, so for the next topic of this lesson we will go, that is the gap. Actually students, we are going, we are dependent on the natural resources, right? But our over-exploitative nature is harming to the environment. Our behavior is not good towards the environment, and because of it, what happens? There are some evil effects are taking place into the environment. Means ecological balance is not maintained, and we are responsible for it because we are being very much greedy towards the nature, right? Our behavior is not, means these resources are for the useful for us. Means we have to use them very judiciously and very properly. But what we are doing, we are exploiting them into the large extent. And our exploitative nature is shown by Ganga Action Plan. Ganga Action Plan is designed because of our over-exploitative nature. So what is meant by this Ganga Action Plan? What exactly it means? What are the objectives of it? What are the aspects are seen in this? So we are going to talk today about Ganga Action Plan. In short, it is written as GAP. Okay, in short, it can be written as a GAP. GAP means Ganga Action Plan. Students, you are knowing, since childhood you are hearing about the river Ganga. Ganga is the holy river for us. Okay, means we have a specific importance for the river Ganga. So you are quite, if you have not seen maybe, but you are knowing the importance of the river Ganga. The water is never getting polluted, it is being saved. But now, that is absolutely wrong. The river Ganga has turned out into the huge drainage system nowadays. Okay, nowadays it has turned, because of our activities, into the huge drainage system. So what are the measures taken against it? We will see. Ganga is actually, Ganga and its tributaries are the largest river system in India. It has been given a symbol of purity since ancient Indian times. Because this river is holy for us. We are something, we are, means we think, we see some goddess and god into the Ganga river. We feel that Ganga river is a goddess for us. So, since ancient time, it has a symbol of a purity, right? And this river is flowing across 2500 kilometers from Gangotri in the Himalaya, and it ends into the Ganga Sagar into the West Bengal. Okay, means total its shore is of 2500 kilometers. How much it is? 2500 kilometers. And it starts flowing from Gangotri in the Himalaya and meet to the Bay of Bengal. Okay, into the Ganga Sagar, West Bengal. It is reaching there. So that bank of this river is of 2500 kilometers. Okay, and it is being polluted. It is being polluted because of more than 100 cities and towns of what? Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. Okay, this river is mainly polluted because of hundreds of more cities and towns of what? Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. Means these three states are responsible more for the Ganga's pollution. Okay? 1/10 of the population of our country, 1/10 of the population is living near to the bank of the Ganga. Okay? So whenever this is flowing, a large amount of pollution it causes, because untreated sewage. The major reason is what for the pollution of Ganga? The largely untreated sewage, garbage, human excreta is directly dumped every day into the river Ganga. It is every day dumped into the river Ganga. What is largely untreated sewage as well as human excreta and garbage. Along with it, some are activities, human activities are also contributing for the pollution of the Ganga. Okay, because of this also toxicity is increasing of the Ganga. What are our activities? Bathing, first of all, most of the people are going and first taking bath into the Ganga. So bathing, then after bathing, washing of clothes into the Ganga. After it, immersion of ashes and unburnt corpses, means after burning the dead body, some remains of the dead bodies are remaining. That is called as a unburnt corpses. And these unburnt corpses, immersion of ashes, bathing, that after it washing of clothes, this is also one more important reason for the pollution of the Ganga. As well as near to the bank of the Ganga, there are various industrial plants or factories are developed, and these factories are directly throwing their effluent, chemical effluent into the Ganga, untreated chemical effluent. Actually, what industries has to do, they have to first, they should have a sewage treatment plant or effluent, chemical effluent treatment plant. The industry should have, means first they have to convert that chemicals into the neutral form. It should not be acidic or it should not be basic. It has to be a neutral, and then that water can be thrown into the any river body or any water body. But these things or these norms of the government are not followed by some industrialists, and they are directly throwing untreated chemical effluents are directly throwing into the water, which is also the major reason, or this activity is also contributing for the pollution of the Ganga. Then what happens as all these things are polluting the Ganga? Then what happens? It affects on the marine life or the aquatic life. Aquatic life contains plants and animals. So it is majorly affect on the plants and animals which are present into the river Ganga. Now the Ganga has polluted a lot. The toxicity, the pollutants are increasing day by day into the Ganga, and Ganga has turned out into the drainage system. So what actions can be taken? So what government has done? Government has done to reduce the pollution and to save the Ganga, rupees 550 crores project has developed. Okay, and that project is called as a Ganga Action Plan in year 1985. To save Ganga, to clean the water of Ganga, the government has used the project, okay, has developed the project of 550 crore rupees, or 550 crore rupees project has developed to save Ganga in 1985. It is launched in 1985 by the government. Why this project is developed? What is exactly the motto or the purpose to develop this project? The motto, main motto, is to install the sewage treatment plant. The major, it is, this project is mainly formulated for the sewage treatment plant. Sewage treatment plant. In short, it can be written as a STP.
Or towns, which
sewage treatment plant. Okay, and this sewage treatment plants can be utilized to purify the river Ganga. Not only river Ganga, other projects were also launched. Which are those? That are Gomati Action Plan. Gomati is also a river. Gomati Action Plan, Satluj Action Plan, Yamuna Action Plan were also launched by the government. Means back of Ganga Action Plan, immediately they tried to clean other rivers also, because other rivers were also polluted because of our activities. Understood? But again, GAP second has also launched. GAP first has launched in 1985. Again, in 1993, GAP second has launched. And the same, motto is same. What are the purposes to have this Ganga Action Plan? To clean the river, right? To reduce the toxicity, to reduce the pollutant from the Ganga. Okay? For this objective only, Ganga Action Plan second has launched in 1993. GAP second is launched for what? To clean the Ganga again. Then what are the major aspects which comes into the Ganga Action Plan? We are going, simply we say to clean the Ganga and to remove the pollutants and toxins from the river Ganga, the Ganga Action Plan has launched twice. But exactly what are the aspects are taking place? Means if the students, the question will be asking what are the aspects they have kept in mind and they have tried this or they have launched these projects. So what are those? The first aspect of it is construction of the community toilets. Construction of community toilets. Because human excreta was responsible for the pollution of the Ganga. So, construction of the community toilet is one of the major important factor for the or aspect to clean river Ganga. Second is what? Treatment of sewage. Treatment of sewage. Sewage. And changing it into energy source. Okay, this is second one, treatment of sewage, because sewage is the major pollutant. Sewage is responsible for the major pollution of the Ganga. So treatment of sewage and changing it into energy source. Okay, sewage treatment plant, in its standard you go or somewhere else you go and see sewage treatment plant, how does it work? So we get to know that we can create some manures also for the farming practices. So second aspect is treatment of sewage and changing it into energy source. Third is what? Development of sewage treatment plant. This is the main motto. Then next, fourth is what? Enforcement to the industries. Enforcement to the industries to develop chemical effluent treatment plant. Because what industrialists were doing, only bank of river Ganga, there should be a proper ghat system. Okay, means just like stairs system, construction of ghats. After it, development or construction of crematorium. See students, construction of crematorium. Crematorium means what? Here the dead bodies are burned. Okay, so here construction of electric crematorium. Electric, because if we will use the simple crematorium. Crematorium means students, Smashan Bhumi in Marathi or Shamshan in Hindi. Crematorium means Smashan. Okay, here the dead bodies are burned. So electrical crematorium is mainly focused. Why electrical? Because in electrical crematorium, what happens? The dead bodies remains, do not remain. Because immersion of ashes is our ritual. We throw ashes directly into the Ganga. So if it will be it would be electric, then what can happen? We cannot throw it directly. Means if we will throw it, then you only ash will go. So electrical crematorium is a major factor. Okay, or this is also comes under the Ganga action plan. So these are the major aspects which are taking place into the Ganga action plan. There are some measurable factors which determine the quality of the water as well as the toxicity of the water, or how much pollutants are dissolved into the water. Means if the quality of the water is not good, or toxins or pollutants are included in most amount into the water, then such water we cannot utilize for our daily purposes such as drinking, bathing, washing clothes. We cannot utilize. So here are some sophisticated measurements through which we can determine the quality of the water as well as the degree of pollution of the water we can determine. So here are four main sophisticated equipments or tools are there through that we can measure the quality of the water as well as the toxicity of the water. So first is what? Coliform count. Coliform count. Second is BOD. BOD means biological oxygen demand. Third is total dissolved substance. Total dissolved substances. And fourth one is pH method. So one by one I shall explain you. Coliform count. This coliform bacteria is present into the human intestine. Okay, if the coliform bacteria would found more into the water, means that the water is polluted because of the human excreta. Understood? Coliform count is the actually measure, or it's an equipment to measure the pollution of any water body. If the coliform count is more, because this bacteria is found into the human intestine, means if the coliform bacteria is some kind of bacteria, if it will found in more into any river or any water body, means that water is polluted by the human excreta and causes various kinds of diseases. Okay, microorganisms are also present around it. So coliform count is also one major equipment to measure the pollution of the any water body. Second is BOD, means biological oxygen demand. See your students, oxygen is required for the aquatic animals. For what? For inhalation, means for breathing process, as well as for the respiration process we require oxygen. Understood? If this oxygen is 1500 milliliters water body is polluted in a excess amount. So second method is what? Biological oxygen demand. We require oxygen for breathing process as well as for the respiration process. Okay, aquatic animals require if it is 1500 milligram per liter, then it is less polluted. If it is between 1500 to 4000 milligram per liter, then it is medium polluted. And if it is found in more than 4000 milligram per liter, then the water body is completely, means in an excess amount it is polluted. TDS means total dissolved substances. See, as students, we are knowing we can determine the hardness and the softness of the water by how much amount some salts are dissolved in it. Okay, we are knowing the sea water is most, means it is hard water because it contains various kinds of salts in it. Means we cannot use such water for drinking purpose, for any other purpose.
Another dress is jeans.
are bringing our grains and our pickles, jams or into the container. That container, we can wash it and we can utilize it. That will come into repurpose. Or empty envelopes also we can utilize to make a list of our grocery or any other things. So you can imagine it, you can repurpose it. It's up to you how we can repurpose the things which we have already. Okay? So some decorative material, you can decorate your home through that repurpose material. So here third R is repurpose. Okay? The next R is what? Recycle. Recycle means what? There are two kinds of waste. We have seen biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. Mainly non-biodegradable waste comes metals and glass. Understood? So what we have to do, that metals means first of all we have to separate the garbage. Okay? And after separating, if the non-biodegradable waste is there, then we have to give it. We have to separate it. We have to again recycle it into the industry. But here what happens? Again we have to energy. Means we have to recycle plastic material, we can take glass material, we can take, or we can take metals, some material. That material can be recycled and can be reused. Okay, but what happens to you students when we recycle? Again we have to consume some energy. Okay, so recycle and reuse. So how many answers are there? Refuse, reduce, repurpose, recycle and reuse. The action plan.